Welcome to the Pauper Gauntlet. I'm playing Burn. It's round three. The Pauper Gauntlet is brought to you by mtgotickets.com. Shout out to Jason at mtgotickets, who have been very helpful during the Pauper Gauntlet. Right, I am playing Burn in round three. The runner-up from last year. Can we get as far as we did? Did I win 12 straight with this deck last year? I think I did. All right, here we go. Vamser is about to get burned out. We want to play first. This is definitely playable. And I'm going to play Forgotten Cave, then play Mountain, and then kill the Marauders. Kill the Marauders. Fire Blast. Yay! And I am starting. So play the Forgotten Cave. Let's hope it's not Delver. That is a horrible matchup. I assume that the life gain white weenie deck is pretty bad as well. He is not giving us any information. No information for us. Curse or Kill the Marauders? I think a Kill the Marauders is correct when we don't know what we are playing against. Because it is just so much damage so quickly. Did he just miss to use his Evolving Wilds? I think he did. Uh-oh, life gain land. Now I'm thinking Azorius Kitty like deck. Just another Kill the Marauders then. Getting the full five for a Kill the Marauder is fantastic. And we should not let Kabir Crossroads detract us from that amazing occurrence. This could be an island. Yes, it is Azorius Kitty. Acid Trip. Maybe it's that new deck. Could be that new deck. With the Tireless Tribe. We have a pretty sweet hand as well. I'm going to go Curse here. I think this will go long and Curse will be able to do more damage than the other cards. If we get it down quickly. He chooses not to shuffle the library. He's good with the next three draws. Okay. Well, I guess you don't take three then. So that's pretty good. I just wish I could destroy it. So we got him down to 15. That's okay. Bye bye, Kill the Marauders. And here is the curse. This is a lot of damage though. 10, 15, I still think it's the curse. When it can't be countered. He can counterspell stuff. If he isn't Azorius Kitty, he can counterspell stuff. If he's Counter Kitty, he can counterspell stuff. If he's the blue-white control deck, he cannot. How many mountains do we play? 17. Two Forgotten Caves. Lone Missionary would be horrible now. But it's a Skyfisher for the crossroads is still pretty slow. I will Searing Blaze the Skyfisher if I, when I fetch a land. When I get a land. But right now I think it's a double bolt to the face. Flame Rift seems a bit risky this early. So I better do it when he's untapped. He is at 9. Where are my mountains? Yeah, he's just bouncing the land. That's good, clean life gain. Puts a card on top, puts a card on top, puts a card on top, and shuffle it. So there is a crisis. He's at 11. Mountain, please. Really want a mountain. He has gained a tremendous amount of life here. This time it's a mountain. It is. So we have a chance to fire blast him now, which we will of course not do yet. Searing Blaze. He's at 8. So Flame Rift Fire Blast does finish him. And Curse of the Pierced Heart has done more damage than any other card, or will do more damage than any other card. Hope it is Reality Acid. No, it's Heliod's Pilgrim. And that means I win. What does he search for? This will be interesting. Fate's Feathers. But it is too little too late. Is that 4 life? Close but no cigar. The Rift. Chain Lightning. Now he can actually daze me. Oh, he still dies to the Curse of the Pierced Heart. Alright. So I'm thinking Azorius Kitty here. I hope it is in the sideboard plan. Ready for Affinity Bogles. Let's look at this together. Affinity Bogle, Delver, Delver Fiend, Esper Familiars, Mono Black Control, Metalcraft, Stompy Teachings, Tron Turbofog, no AC Kitty, no Acid Trip. So the cards of interest then are of course Pyroblast, but I am not a fan of Pyroblast because Pyroblast just does not do any damage. And is this really a Flaring Pain deck? Because getting around the Circle of Protection with Flaring Pain is hard work. Molten Rain. This was hard. What do I take out against Controlish decks? Against Familiars we take out Incinerate and Needle Drop, of course. Needle Drop is very bad against control decks. But he doesn't have counter spells. He will have Pyroblast though. So I'm taking out the Needle Drops, bringing in two Flaring Pains. But what if he doesn't have any damage prevention? And I'm thinking Molten Rain is better than Pyroblast. Because what blue cards do we really fear? If he starts to Mull Rifter, we have just lost. So Pyroblast is strictly for the Delver matchup, I think, or Delver Fiend. or familiars. So this is how I'm sideboarding against the Sorius Kitty. This should be a hard matchup. Lone Missionaries will hurt. I'm forcing through enough burn through a circle of protection with flaring pace. Sounds very expensive. There's a curse. Searing Blaze is, of course, this is a keep. Let's hope we can just run it over. But we had to do a lot more than 20 damage last game. Not the fastest hand. I really don't like Incinerate. I think it is super expensive. So now he can have a counterspell, but I don't think... Not the Lone Missionary. It is a Lone Missionary. Oh, it's just Scorf Skyfisher. Okay, then we probably have to Searing Blaze it now. This is such a perfect opportunity. And we don't know if we can Searing Blaze it later. So I guess we just have to do it. Setting it back to 20-20 and 6 cards. Yeah, Spreading Seas. Very Azorius Kitty. Okay, so I'm playing the curse now. But I'm getting stuck on land again. And I have a long uphill road to walk. And now I have to draw a mountain. Or actually, the other land works as well. But I can't bolt the Skyfisher. It has to be Searing Blaze. I think it is Keldon Marauders and hopefully draw into the Searing Blaze next turn. That would do a ton of damage. Stuck on two lands again, but it is very statistically likely that I get stuck on two lands. And he's stuck on two lands as well, it seems. Or is he? We don't know that yet. No such fun. Please don't play a land, that would be fantastic. But he does have a land, of course. So there's the Searing Blaze. And it's all we can do because somebody wrecked one of our lands. But he has no clock. And we have a clock, the slowest clock in the world. This thing is not a mountain, no. So it cannot be sacrificed to Fire Blast. I do have, in my hand, 17 damage. Riftwatcher. No, it's an Evoked Muldrifter. That's fantastic. So now I'm gonna Lava Spike Incinerate, I think. He has not played the land yet. So he probably will. But it's a ponder, so no counterspell. On top. He does not shuffle, so stuff is going to happen to me. Wow. Okay, let's do it while he's tapped out. If he plays a Muldrifter here, he dies. He has to gain life. That guy is terrible for us. I think we would have seen a Hydro Blast at this point. So much life gain. And now we have to save the bolt and bolt the lone missionary if he bounces it. Yeah, if he's going to bounce it, we will have to kill it. Or will we? If he goes to 14 land, then we cannot kill him, so... He will then just bounce the Radiant Fountain instead. So in fact, bolting the Lone Missionary just does 2 damage instead of 3 if we cast it to his face. So we let it happen. Haven't we dealt with all the Skyfishers already? No, just 2. I'm gonna Lava Spike his face. Six. Or just a Muldrifter. Please be a Muldrifter. Ah, tight. Still dead though. But he has a blue mana up for the decisive Hydro Blast. But if I had a Hydro Blast here, it would suck so bad. Right now it would be really good, but it's very likely that it would not be good. So I don't know if I dare go for it here. Okay, if he bounces something, I have to go for it. But if he has it here, I think I must think that he has it. So I'm going to suspend the Rift Bolt. And try to bolt kill him. If he does anything that gains him life. Just playing a Radiant Fountain I can't interact with. But I may get stuck without any mountains. It's the Dreamstalker, so now we have to go for it. And I think it is correct to go for it here, because if this fails, he will win anyway. We let him get an extra draw for Hydro Blast. So does he have the Hydro Blast or not? He doesn't. Yes! Burn is in the fourth round of the Pauper Gauntlet. Thank you for watching.